Life, a place to explore, a place to get bruises and a place to slip up.
Remember how you first learned to ride your bike? You didn't just learn that straight away. You got on and you fell off.
You get back on your feet and try again.
You don't just get it first time. It probably took months of trying again and again.
What my love of sport has given me is a never give up attitude. If something goes wrong, I pick myself up and climb back to the top.
How many times have you thought, I wish I got everything right? But Einstein saw the value of not getting things right first time when he said, the important thing is not to stop questioning.
Whether at school or at home, failure isn't always seen as a good thing. I mean, who wants to be the one in the corner crying because they can't get it right? Who wants to be the one at the bottom when all your friends are at the top? Who wants to be the one ignored, left alone? Well, I don't.
I was nearly 4 years old. I remember referring to primary school as big school. It made me feel grown up when I talked about it. I was excited about what I would learn there and about what doors it would open.
My parents thought I was going to be clever from a young age. I started walking and talking around 8 months old. I was always the angel in the nativity. I got put at the front in the choir and I had the solo in the gymnastics competition.
From a very young age, we have been taught to get things right. I remember when I was about 7, we used to do these maths tests. I found them pretty easy.
Naturally, I assumed that the skills I was learning would help me to succeed when I was an adult. But recently, I have learnt that reports such as those by McKinsey or CBI keep concluding that young people are being educated in a world completely parallel to the world of work.
Perhaps it will be useful for us to experience some real-world skills, like collaboration, communication, resilience, and adaptability.
We need to be building bridges from our classroom learning to the real world to experience more of the challenges we all face in the world of work.
In my opinion, this label, we are the people who get things right, is a burden. How? It's a burden because once it's been placed upon you, you can't be seen to fail. You can't learn from your mistakes because you can't make any.
I certainly wasn't prepared to make mistakes.
Everybody wants to get things right, but how do we truly succeed without failing?
So what has to change? Our school culture. In fact, I would say our whole culture has to rethink how we perceive failure.
Because if it doesn't change, then I and millions of other children will be learning to live in a world which no longer exists.
What we should all know is that there's no surefire way to succeed. But by making a mistake, picking yourself up, gritting your teeth and carrying on, you're one step further along the uneven path of life.